So here we have the Fiat 500C, which is the convertible, on a 16 plate. I'm going to start off by showing you around the outside of the car, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But from the outside, you can see it's a three-door car with alloy wheels. Let's start off inside the boot and then work our way around the rest of the car from there. As we approach the boot, you can see we have reversing sensors. Plenty of boot space given the size of the car, along with that 50-50 split folding rear seat as well. Okay, so we're just going to work our way back round to the front of the car, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But now that we've done a full circle of it, you can see it's in excellent condition the whole way round. Just briefly before we climb in, I think it's well worth seeing the interior from this exterior point of view. There's plenty to run through on the dashboard, so let's hop in and we'll do that now. Okay, now that we're inside the car, we're going to start with the dials. We have the white outer ring, which is the speedometer. We have the rev counter within that, and then the trip computer in the central section, which includes the fuel gauge and coolant temperature gauges. It also shows the total miles for this car, which are 48,837. If we back out to the steering wheel, on the left-hand side, we have stereo controls, which continue on the right, along with the phone controls just there. You can only use the phone controls after such time as you pair the phone up, which is done on the central touchscreen here. We are going to not pair one for the moment. When it comes to music, we have the radio, of course. And you'll see there we have AM and FM radio. If you want to listen to your own music, you can do. Nothing is connected at the moment, but you can connect up an auxiliary device, a USB device, and whatever device you connect will show up on here. And you can see we have Bluetooth audio, auxiliary. It's a little hard to see in the middle because of the sunlight, and USB there. But when you connect them, they will all be in this kind of white color, so they're much clearer and easier to see, and you'll know you've got a connection there as well. You can also connect up your smartphone via its USB, and you will be able to get certain Fiat-friendly apps displayed up on this screen as well. Working our way down, we have the city button to make the power steering lighter, hazard warning lights, and front and rear fog lights. We then have the air conditioning, so you can determine the temperature, fan speed, direction of the air is here, and you can bring in fresh air from outside the car or recirculate the air that's in the car, depending on the temperature you've set over on this dial. That's a great way of heating the car up quickly or cooling it down quickly here. To turn the air conditioning on, you'll see it's on at the moment. That light will come on within the button to let you know. So it's now off or back on again with our rear heated screen just there. We're able to turn off the stop and start from over here, as well as turning off the traction control. We then have driver and passenger electric windows, a 5-speed manual gearbox, and down the bottom here, a 12-volt charging socket, as well as the auxiliary and USB inputs I mentioned a moment ago. The last thing I want to talk about is the roof. So we have a button up here, give that a push and the roof will start to open up for you, as you can see. Now it will stop when it reaches the rear window, but give it another push and it will cover that rear window section to give you this massive, massive open space, as you can see. All that leaves me to say is thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you'd like to come and see the car in person and have a test drive, please feel free to call any of our MJA sites. We'd love to hear from you soon.